थैंक यू डॉक्टर सुनेत्रा मैडम. सो डियर पार्टिसिपेंट्स, सो आई थिंक यू विल बी कंफर्टेबल इन इंग्लिश. ओके ना? ओके. सो प्लीज ट्राई टू नोट डाउन द पॉइंट्स वेर एवर इट इज़ रिक्वायर्ड फॉर यू, एंड यू कैन आस्क एनी योर डाउट्स और क्वेश्चंस एट द एंड ऑफ द दिस सेशन. सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट टेक्निकल सेशन. सो please be cautious, and because this is important, because when you go to field, no, you will come across with lot of problems. So when you start doing, so at least so if you can learn something in this, so it will be useful. At least Anganwadi workers you can tell tomorrow. So coming to this, today's my lecture is on nutrition garden layout and nutritive value of the vegetables. So briefly we will learn it. So this may be around 40 minutes lecture. So you just start with. So balanced diet. So very well you are aware. So what is the balanced diet? So balanced diet is very much essential for the sound mind of our body. So it is very much essential to us. So and for balanced diet, you should know always what to eat. So how much to eat. These two things if you learn, so it is very good for us always. So unlike plants, so are these human beings or animals are biological this thing. So they cannot produce their own food. So plants, they will produce their own food because nobody will feed them. Because they have the root system, they have with the light, the photosynthesis, they will produce the required food. So but animals and our human beings, they are solely dependent on plants or other animal-based food. So that's why it is a limiting factor how much we have to eat, what to eat. So these two things we have to learn in this lesson. So kindly concentrate. So lack of food, either of quality or quantity. So this is the only thing which you have to amend. So Nutritali, what you will tell so to Anganwadi worker, it is there nothing but quality and quantity of the food. How much you have to take. And fruit and vegetables form a part of balanced diet. As you all know, along with rice or chapatis, we have to take equal amount of fruits and vegetables. Morning I have already told, so it is recommended around 300 grams of vegetables per day and 100 gram minimum of fruits per man per day for a balanced diet and healthy diet. So this you keep it in your mind. So and this why fruits and vegetables? So it is a good source of vitamins and minerals. They are antioxidants, they are fiber oriented, and it provides protective to our body, especially immunization of our body. This is very much essential. So coming to this triangle diagram, you have already seen. So Anganwadi, everywhere it is there. So this I need not have to explain much. So of course, at the bottom, that much water you have to take. So 8 servings per day. So next in the table comes rice, pasta, and 6 servings. 6 servings should be there. So after that, so fortified cereal or bread you have to heat. So around 3. So this 3 plus 3 means 6. So second to that. So as our triangle sharpens, we have to reduce the quantity and servings. So next is the vegetable. So vegetable group 3 servings and fruit 2 servings. So next milk, yogurt and cheese. So these are all next line for diet it will come. Of course it is matching with meat, poultry, fish, dry beans and nuts. So these are all around 2 servings in a day for a balanced diet. So apart from the fat, you can see it is coming at the top. So we have to be cautious in eating. So oils, especially sweets. So this sparingly we have to use. In addition to that, to our diet we have to always add calcium, vitamin D, vitamin B12 supplements. Always we have to take. So this forms the balanced diet for us. So coming to vegetables today's talk, so I can tell you why we have to eat vegetables, what are its importance, so how it will serve our health and our body and other. So first of all, so all the vegetables, they are why? Because they are very low in fat. So even if you eat 1 kg of vegetable per day, so no fatty will be added to your body. So it is very good. And so calories also low. So that's why it no accumulation in our body. So you need not have to work hard for the disposal of the calories which you take in the form of food daily. And all have no cholesterol. So that is the added point. Vegetables if you consume, so no cholesterol will be added to our body. Further, they are the important source including potassium, fiber, folic acid, vitamin A and vitamin C. So further, dietary fiber. So fiber is very much essential to our body, especially to solve the problem of constipation. So these vegetables will serve a lot to our body. So apart from this, it controls our blood cholesterol levels and also our bowel function properly. The vegetables will serve us. So further, they are rich in potassium, which will maintain our blood pressure properly. So that's why there are a lot of vegetables we have to take. Further, it helps folic acid to our body to form red blood cells. So body fighting against immunization and all. So red blood cells formation is also essential. So that is also important. So vitamin A, you may be knowing, it is more of in drumstick, so leafy vegetables. So this contains a lot of vitamin A, which will help to maintain our skin properly and eye function properly. These two are very much essential to our body. Apart from this, vitamin C. So as you know, in the present context, corona, so a lot of immunization is required to our health. So by taking vegetables, vitamin C component also add to our body, and it serves in many ways. So coming to minerals, so they are very much essential to our body function, so metabolism, physiological, so protein chain formation, cell formation, everywhere the minerals are very much essential. So it is nowhere available except in vegetables and fruits. So that's why so important minerals like calcium, phosphorus, iron, sodium, potassium, magnesium, zinc and copper is very much available in our vegetables, and which is very much essential to our body to function. So let us study so vegetables. So by eating tomato, what is available to our body? So nutrient content and function for the vegetables. So this will go one by one with vegetables. So by eating different type of vegetables, what it will be added and how it will be helpful. Coming to tomato, so lycopene pigment, tomato fruits contains lycopene. That color changing, no? You may be seen that raw tomatoes, they are of green. When they will turn to red, due to lycopene formation. So it contains lot of lycopene. So this is an antioxidant. So even it fights against cancer also. So this is very much good. By eating tomatoes, people get sufficient quantities. So as I have given, a single tomato can provide so 40% of the daily requirement of the vitamin C. So of course, everybody we are using nowadays commonly tomatoes in our diet. So in our house, so daily we are using. Of course, it is serving in vitamin C supplement, which is a natural antioxidant. So high potassium helps to maintain so our normal health and blood levels. So further, iron also helps to so blood health. So tomato contains vitamin K also, so especially in blood clotting, so it plays a vital role. So further, it also helps in high health and prevents hypertension and urinary tract infections. So tomato is a very good vegetable, so which you can eat daily. So through this, you can achieve all these things. So coming to chili and capsicum. So chili is a common thing which we use daily in our diet. So it is an excellent source of vitamin C, E and carotenoids. So it is high in anti-inflammatory and antioxidant compounds. So it is a natural cancer fighter vegetable. So particularly gastric cancer and esophageal cancers. So by eating can. So it is also heart healthy additional diets, particularly when eaten raw. You may be knowing many people, they used to consume chili along with rotis. So it adds to digestion. So it helps in digestion and it fights, so heart to function properly. So this is a good practice what our Indians are doing in the age old days. So eating raw chili, so along with this rotis and all, so it serves very well to our body. So coming to cucurbits, so of course this is a big family, so where we have neglected. If you see pumpkin, loki or kaddu or cucumber or turai or this what you say that snake gourd, everything, this is a big family of vegetables, cucurbits. So cucurbit means it belongs to cucurbitaceae. All cucurbit vegetables belong to cucurbitaceae family, so which will spread over the ground or it will trade to the trees. So this is a big group of vegetables. See, you may be knowing this was going in growing in jungles also earlier. So that wild type of these cucurbits will be consumed by our tribal people. They are quite healthy compared to us because of this eating of lot of leafy vegetables and cucurbits at that time. So it is serves as a rich source of vitamin A, vitamin C, magnesium, fiber, folate, riboflavin, phosphorus, potassium, and vitamin B6. So these are all the specially vitamins and other things which are very much available in this cucurbits. Apart from this, manganese. So manganese is a mineral which is essential for our body in fat, in the processing of fats, glucose, and carbonates. So this is also very much essential to our body, which is available in especially watermelon. Watermelon is not a fruit, it is a vegetable. So muskmelon is a vegetable. So even though they are look like fruits, but they belong to vegetable group. So further, so contain negligible fat. So as I already told, no vegetables, they contain fat and less cholesterol. So beta carotene is very high in these cucurbitaceae vegetables. They are very good for our high health. So further, as a cancer fighting properties are more in these cucurbitaceae vegetables, and especially for women, PMS problem symptoms also will be solved by eating more of cucurbitaceae vegetables. So coming to cucumber, so it is a daily vegetable which we consume. Even salads also we will consume. Why we will consume? Because it is high fiber vegetable, so which will help in our maintenance of bowel. So constipation problem will be avoided. So that's why it is a practice, age old practice, when we start our diet, so we consume lot of this cucumber, so along with others. So cucumber is, it contains three important lignins, so they are very essential in reducing our cardiovascular diseases. So also further, it also help to fight against cancers, especially breast, uterine, ovarian, and prostate cancers. Further, it is an antioxidant, anti-inflammatory properties it doesn't contain. And research also indicates that cancer fighting properties particularly benefit women. So by eating more of cucumber, so lot of things will be added with, for fighting against cancer. So good source of beta carotene, vitamin A, and manganese. And it is further, the easiest thing is, it is even, nobody will cook the cucumber, as you know. There many people will eat as raw because it is easily digestible. So that is the excellent property of this cucumber. So next is group is legume vegetables. So this legume vegetables contains French bean, so kopi, or mutter, pea, and other, so especially the cluster bean. So cluster bean is a very good legume vegetable which you are consuming. I see in all the shops it's available. It's a very good vegetable. So this is especially this group of vegetables, so contain so low saturated fat and cholesterol, and further low sodium also in these vegetables. And it is a good source of protein, thiamine, riboflavin, niacin, vitamin B6, calcium, iron, magnesium, phosphorus, potassium, and copper. All these minerals are available with legumes. Legume is a very good vegetable for our daily diet. And it is a very good source of fiber. So especially Gurkha powder, you may be knowing. So even Gujarat, so they don't produce this gaur, so for vegetable. So even in only in southern states we consume it as a vegetable. So whereas Gujarat and Rajasthan, they grow it for powder purposes. So they produce lot of powder in this cluster bean after growing. So they will make it a powder, and daily they at the night before going to bed, they will consume 1 teaspoon of this ghar powder, which helps in constipation. So bowel function will be very well. So that is the advantage, where the lot of fiber is available. And further, it is a good antioxidant and fights against cancer and heart diseases. So fiber, I have already told. So it helps to fight against type 2 diabetes. So consuming of these legume vegetables are very much essential to our body for our health. Next is cabbage and cauliflower. So coming to this is called as English vegetables. Earlier we were not consuming much. So this cruciferous family, especially cabbage, cauliflower, collards, broccoli, Brussels sprouts and all. So they are the very rich group of and excellent source of nutrients vegetables. So they are high in vitamin K, C, B1, B6, copper, potassium, minerals like copper, potassium, manganese, and high fiber content will be there, and especially choline is also there. Rich in antioxidants, anti-inflammatory products, and gluconeogenesis. Excellent source of fiber, I already told. So it is a good fiber vegetables. So, and especially it helps in food passage, digestion, healing of stomach ulcers, and cardiovascular health problems. So that is the only vegetable which is very soft. So you know the cauliflower. So that is the part of the flower we are using as a vegetable. So not any part of the plant. So flower is our main vegetable. So no other vegetables we will consume in the form of flower. So cauliflower only we consume as a flower. Even so, you may be knowing. So what is cabbage? What part of the plant? Is it a stem, flower, leaf? Can you tell? Very good. It is a leafy vegetable. So cabbage is a leafy vegetable. So cauliflower is a flower vegetable. So root vegetables are radish, carrot, onion, potato. These are all rooty vegetables. So this madam will tell you in the next lectures regarding this. Now this is very good actually for the health point of view, onion and garlic. So garlic all you will consume, no? Yeah, that is very much very good, especially it contains a lot of medicinal values to our body. So it is a flavonoids. So if you fry onion in the house in a frying pan, so lot of odor will be around our house or neighboring places, because it contains a lot of flavonoids. So that is only available in this group of vegetables. So even in garlic and onion, this is a very good character of these vegetables. So it contains vitamin C, B6, fiber, manganese, molybdenum, tryptophan, folate, potassium, phosphorus, copper, and flavonoids such as already. So it reduces the risk of heart disease, especially if you consume especially garlic. So garlic, it reduces our blood flow. It regulates our blood flow in the body. So it thins the blood. So easy blood movement will be there. So especially it serves in the heart disease, especially our garlic. So balanced blood sugar levels also, it will help in maintenance, and it has a antiviral, antibacterial properties. So it also special character of this vegetables. This is all about vegetables and their importance, and how we have to consume. So this I already told. So we should have balanced. Don't eat all the vegetables one day. You can advise the workers to train the local women in preparing a chart. So Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, so that all group of vegetables should be consumed in a week. So especially leafy vegetables, please give more attention, where it contains rich iron. So madam will tell about it. So iron source is very high, so in leafy vegetables, so it will add to our hemoglobin content increase in our blood. So especially anemic and all, so it avoids that problems. So leafy vegetables we have to do, and legumes one day, and tomato, garlic, onion and all daily you can eat. So especially I don't advocate eating much of potato. Potato is not a good vegetable. So maximum I can recommend to consume only 50 grams per day. Don't eat much. So Western and countries, they don't consider potato as a vegetable. So it is a staple food for them. So in place of rice or wheat, they consume potato. But in India, we are reverse. Along with rice, along with wheat, we equally eat potatoes. What will happen? This is a rich, carbohydrate rich vegetable. So it doesn't contain lot of starch. Along with the rice and the other wheat or maida, whatever you consume daily. So it also adds lot of carbohydrate to our body. By this, what will happen? So lot of carbohydrate accumulation is there. Nowadays, we are not working. We are sitting and doing our jobs. Due to this, lot of calories will be stored out to our body. So it adds to our increase in size, and even our blood capillary, microcapillary tubes will be filled with this glucosinolates and the heart problem and all, especially further our diabetic. So this is the main problem with us. So don't consume potato much in your daily diet. So maximum, so it is, it contains very good. Apart from that, it contains lot of carbohydrate. So if you don't eat rice, you eat potato, no problem. So full plate potato you take and eat. You don't eat chapatis or rice that day. So that's okay. As your different people are doing, it's okay. But don't eat potato along with rice and chapatis. So wheat, nowadays wheat is also equally contributing to rice. So you might have read a lot of articles, Western articles. So wheat is not a good source. As our doctors are indicating, diabetic means you take chapatis. So wheat is not a good diet for diabetic patients. So much of cereals you have to go. So in our further lectures, that also will be made aware. So nutri-rich cereals you have to consume more for our diet problems. So this is all in nutshell about the vegetables and its importance and its importance in our diet. So please make it clear. I think some of the information you have captured, so please store it and try to pass on this message to your Anganwadi workers. So coming to layout, so this training is basically for you about the nutri garden or kitchen garden or a vegetable garden, whatever you call. So these are all the synonymous names for this. So what is nutri garden? So nutri garden means, that name itself indicates, the family get the sufficient nutrition by growing this garden. So this garden mainly contains vegetables, as I already told. So vegetables are the main components of the nutri garden, apart from fruits, flowers and other plantation crops or medicinal plants. So these are all the components of the nutri garden. So why nutri garden is essential? So nowadays, so it becomes, see, even in Goa, so many times vegetables will not be available. You are procuring from neighboring states. So especially Karnataka or Maharashtra, neighboring states. So there, we don't know how much the farmers have sprayed the insecticide for the production of these vegetables. Due to this, what will happen? So a lot of pesticide residues will be with the vegetables what we are buying in the market. So for that, so you don't have, because farmer wants money. We say, after spraying this pesticide, you have to wait for 15 days for the harvest. So he never used to wait because he wants money. So he will harvest next day, he will bring to the market, and it looks product is very good for, and fresh, ekdam fresh lagte hai. So isliye kya karte hain hum, hamesha, so pasand karke usko kharidte hain. Uska wajah se kya hota hai? So ye hamara, so this is made up of organomethylcarriers, and see, this is cancer, these properties are very much there in the pesticides. So organomethylcarriers. So due to that, unknowingly we are eating lot of pesticide sprayed vegetables daily. So for this, what will happen? So our kidneys are not in a position to eliminate from through our urine. So which it will accumulate in our blood. So then it will become carcinogenic and leads to cancer problems. So to avoid this, your nutrition garden is very much essential, where you can have assurance that you are not sprayed any pesticide. That is the main advantage of growing nutrient garden. Second is, you can have your fresh vegetables. No need of storing them in the refrigerator. So you start cooking, you go to your neighboring outside nutrient garden, you harvest and bring and cut the vegetables and eat it. So it will serve you very well. So that is the second advantage. Third advantage, so you can spend leisurely some time in growing vegetables. You can leisurely spend your time, your stress will come down and your children will also associate with you, and you can spare to your neighbors also as a so privilege. So and they help. So this is the three main advantages of growing nutri garden. So this thing. So coming to layout. So the main objective of the layout is economic utilization of the space. So even in your house side, if some space is available, that only thing we ask you, minimum 5 hours light should be there. Because as I have already told in the beginning, plants, they synthesize their own food, unlike our animals or human beings. So they need their own food. For the synthesis of their own food, light is very much essential. Without light, they cannot photosynthesize their own food. So minimum, you should see that. So 5 hours, that light should pass through that so selected area. This is very much essential. Even in Anganwadis also, you can select such an area which is available, 5 hours light is available. So, and economic utilization of the space. So that is very much important. So whatever the space is available, so as in the next slides I will show you, so how you can utilize the spaces. So if it is available only 3 meters on the one side and 3 meters on the side, both the sides you can cultivate. So one side you can grow fruits and other things, one side on vegetables. It need not be a single piece of to grow the nutri garden. So this is initially you have to think minimum 5 hours and maximum utilization of the seed. Further, so I have told even you can grow separately or together vegetable and fruits. So cropping intensity should be maximum in a nutri garden. What is cropping intensity? So cultivating the crop in the same piece of land number of times in a year, that is called cropping intensity. Suppose if you are having one 10 by 10 meters of piece of land, if you grow one vegetable this for 3 months, then you can so another 3 months one more vegetable, another 3 months one crop. That means 3 times you are using the same piece of land for growing. So annually how much times you are grow, so that is 300% it will come cropping intensity, because the same you are using in a year for 3 times. So that is called cropping intensity. So that means you have to grow once one crop is over, Tamdi Bhaji, if you have grown, so it will grow, finish its life cycle in 40 days. Once it is over, second crop you have to grow in the same piece of land. So that is, you have to intensify the crop and cycle. So generally, for 5 members of the family group, so we advocate 100 square meters. So 100 square meters area of nutri garden will suffix, so 5 member family size. So if the family is having 5 members, so that day. So if your Anganwadi contains some children of 20, at least you should have some 200 square meter. So nutri garden, that much it's available, so that it will supply daily vegetables to our Anganwadi. So this is the plan. So I have already told, so this type of plan you can prepare, and so 5 hours light should be available to your this thing. So you can prepare the plots of like that boxes, so which I have shown, or second is together you can prepare together also. You can divide into number of plots and you can grow individually vegetables in it. So what are the components in this thing? So we will divide them vegetables usually into perennial and annual type. What is perennial and what is annual? So annual is vegetables are one which they can complete their life cycle within 1 year. That will be called as annual vegetable. Annual vegetables means, see, life cycle means it has to grow, it has to put forth flowers, it has to put forth fruit, and it will die. That means it will die within a year. That will be called as annual vegetables. And if the life cycle continues beyond 1 year, that will be called as perennial vegetables. Usually perennial vegetables in our system is drumstick. So moringa. Moringa is a perennial vegetable. So even some same and all. So they continue more than 1 year. So these are all the perennial vegetables, annual vegetables. Usually perennial vegetables should be located at one of the gardens. So why? Because annual vegetables we have to cultivate frequently. So we should not put these perennial vegetables in the center of the, our nutrition garden. So try to locate them at the border so that it will not interfere so with our production of other vegetables. So that's why all perennial vegetables should be located to border areas. This is very much essential. Apart from this, annual vegetables. So keeping crop rotation and vegetables should be grow. So it has to be, you have to divide within the available spaces. So 2 meter, 2 meter, or 1.5 meter, 1 meter, 1 meter plots, as I have shown already previously. And grow minimum 6 crops, 6 vegetables should be accommodated at a time. That means the family should get 6 vegetables. So 6 days in a week, no? So 7 days, so at least one vegetable family should get it. So you plan your layout in such a way that so minimum 6 vegetables, annual vegetables, should be cultivated. So on the borders, next. So you can grow on the borders annual vegetables, dwarf and bushy vegetables, so like drumstick and especially our cucurbits. So they need a trailing, so they will not grow on the ground. You have to make, farmers will make prepare pandals. Instead of that, on the fencing. So usually, nutrition garden always fencing is required to protect from animals and all. So security point. So in the borders, if you grow this cucurbits and this moringa, papaya, and other banana, and all these fruit plants can be accommodated on the border, so which will help you in getting this perennial vegetables regularly to your body. So these annual vegetables you can accommodate. So further we advocate one beehive. So you know that cucurbitaceous are monoecious flowers. That means on the same plant you will get both male and female flowers separately. So without pollination fruit set will not be there. So many times you may come across, so in pumpkin or loki or turai, the fruit flower drop will be there. If you don't get pollination, the flower drop will be there in cucurbits. So the further, if you grow, keep one beehive, so honey also you will get, further it will help in getting more vegetables also. So this is the picture of vegetable. You can see, initially I have shown boxes also you can make. So on the right hand side you can see, so this is the made up of wood they have given. So in the boxes they are growing vegetables, separate plots they have prepared. So it is for internal working and all, it will be grown. If you on the left side you can see, so that cucurbit and vegetables, no, with pendal they have given at the borders. So left small annuals they have grown in between. So like this you have to plan your cucurbit layout for your nutrition garden. So coming to crop selection, so main plots should always contain bhindi, radish, brinjal, cabbage, tomato, chili, amaranthus, gopi, poi, cucumber, tapioca, watermelon, palak, coriander, etc. This should be so on the main plots. This is because very main plots, this is the very essential vegetables to our family. That's why they should be put on the main. On the other hand, so small bunds we will be preparing in between these plots, no? On the bunds you can take nalkol, radish, cabbage, ginger and all you can put. Even turmeric also you can grow. So rotation side, so as I will put on the fence side, you can grow bitter gourd, cucumber, sponge gourd, pumpkin, ridge gourd, butter gourd, kopi, ash gourd, etc. This can be put on the border. Again, fruit. So in our nutrition garden, fruit is also very much essential. Under the nutrition garden, you can grow fruit crops like banana, papaya, guava, mango, sapota, lime, lemon, jackfruit, pineapple, sitapal. These are all very much recommended fruits for nutri garden. So these are all very much essential to our body also. So apart from this, coconut is also essential and arcanut is also essential. If the space is available, you can grow fern. These are all preferences based on the space availability. So first vegetable, next fruit crop, next plantation crop, next spices, black pepper, because this is required in small quantity, you can buy also from the market, not maximum. So these, like this, you have to plant. So amaranthus and all, they have to accommodate in the main plots. Even as we are all mainly flowers is also required for the family. So you can, if the space is available, you can go for so annual and biennial flowers. So like Ajaranthum, Hollyhock, China Aster, Coxcomb, Marigold, Jania, Sunflower, Rose, Jasmine, so Hibiscus, all these flower plants also you can grow in your nursery garden. That means the nursery garden, if sufficient species is available, it should contain mainly vegetables, fruit plants and flowers, and apart from this, plantation crops. Plantation crops like so arcanut and coconut. So this is in how to plant. This is all about the planning of vegetables in the nursery garden, how to go for the layout depending on the availability of the space. So if one side, if space is available, you grow vegetables on one side of the house, other side you can go for fruits. So only thing, please see that so 5 hours sunlight should be available, because plants prepare their own food. So for photosynthesis, sunlight is very much essential. So these you keep in your mind. So apart from this, so cultivation practices. So how to cultivate vegetables? So first thing is nursery karna, so kaise karna, our land preparation, so jameen tayar karna padegi, wo kaise karna hai, so plantings karna hai, kaise karna, application of organic manures, fertilizers, irrigation, intercultural, plant production, harvesting. So these are all the operations to be carried out in a nursery garden. So these are all very much essential. So regarding this, tomorrow I will teach you about all these cultivation practices crop wise. So how to cultivate these crops in the nursery garden. So with this, I will conclude my today's lecture. So tomorrow I will continue for further another 40 minutes. So where can I tell you, teach you about this cultivation of vegetables, how to cultivate individual vegetables. So thank you. So now, you can laugh at the figure. So it contains only vegetables. Okay, no? So this is all about this today's lecture by me. So any doubts, any questions or any clarifications, you can ask. You understood now what I have told? Something has gone to your mind now? At least, what is layout, how to prepare layout, how to put the crops, so what is the essential, by eating tomato, what is the essential, onion, garlic essential. So something yet has gone to your mind, so please try to capture something, so try to tell and inform your Anganwadi workers about this also. Okay, with this I will close down. Any doubts or questions? Okay, if nothing is there, thank you. Thank you. और